Dear students, welcome you all. In this video, I am explaining about 5 marks and 10 marks questions in the chapter number 3. It includes the meaning of civilization and the Egyptian civilization. Part 1. Answer in 15 to 20 sentences. Each carries 5 marks. Question number 1. Define civilization. Distinguish between civilization and culture. Define civilization. Distinguish between civilization and culture. Introduction. The word civilization is derived from Latin word civilis, meaning city or city-states. It stands for more mature and refined life. The word civilization is derived from Latin word civilis. It means city or city-states. Generally, civilization and culture are used as one and the same. Civilization broadly refers to more clearly defined human society. The words civilization and culture are not always considered interchangeable. Following are the important differences between the culture and civilization. The first one. Culture, most of it internal, but relating to the civilization, it is external. Relating to culture, most of it internal, but civilization, it is external. Second one, it includes, means culture includes art, literature, religion, philosophy, food and dress, thoughts and beliefs, customs and traditions. But civilization includes towns, cities, villages, buildings, bridges, transport, technology, etc. Then third one, culture has no standards of measurement. Culture has no standards of measurements. But civilization has standards of measurements. There is a standards of measuring civilization. So these are the few important differences between culture and civilization. Then the fourth one, relating to the culture, it is the way we believe, behave, think and act. Civilization is the material attainments, gains and facilities used to make the life more comfortable. For adding comfortness, material attainment, gains and facilities used to make the life more comfortable is considered as civilization. Fifth one, culture cannot be said to be always advancing. Culture cannot be said to be always advancing. But civilization is always advancing. It is always advancing. The sixth one, culture comes earlier, but civilization goes later. Culture can be culture without civilization, but there cannot be a civilization without culture. These are the important differences between culture and civilization. In conclusion, every civilization has a culture of its own. Sometimes there could be more than one culture in a civilization. Culture is transmitted and transferred. Civilization is entirely passed on. Civilizations grow, degrade, disintegrate and end. Then second one, question number second, discuss the factors that helped the growth of civilization on the riverbanks. I'm adding the term riverbanks. So discuss the factors that helped the growth of civilization. Introduction. Most of the civilizations in the world developed on the banks of the rivers. The places where man settled first were naturally those parts of the world where the soil was rich and water available for drinking and irrigation, along with the warm climate. Some important factors that helped the growth of civilization. First one, deposition of fertile alluvial soil caused by the river floods. Second one, continuous and uninterrupted supply of water for irrigation and domestic purposes. Favorable climate generally found on the river valleys. So fertile alluvial soil, uninterrupted supply of water, then favorable climate. Then fourth one, plenty of food, fruits and vegetables for men and fodder for their animals. Food for men and fodder for their animals. Next one, river valleys helped fishing. Last one, the river valleys helped the growth of trade and communication by providing means of transport. In concluding section, there is a strong argument that men become more civilized if they have leisure to do creative work. It is certain that river valleys provided them food in plenty and sufficient leisure to develop civilizations. Next one, question number 3. Explain the political conditions of Egyptian civilization. Explain the political conditions of Egyptian civilization. Introduction. The early people settled here. The early people means the early people of Egypt settled into the villages, which developed into cities, and later these city-states were formed. These city-states led to beginning of political system in Egypt. They were ruled by kings. These city-states were ruled by the kings. This is known as pre-dynastic period. These kings were engaged in inter-city-state quarrels. This made way to the birth of kingdoms. About 30 dynasties have ruled Egypt for more than 3,000 years. The pharaohs. The Egyptian kings were called pharaohs. They were considered as representatives of God on earth. Hence, they enjoyed unlimited powers. The Pharaoh Menes united South and North Egypt and made Memphis as his capital. The strong central government with absolute monarchy, a well-controlled administration, and strict implementation of laws were the basic features of Egyptian society. The rule of dynasties can be divided into three parts. They are the first one, the period of Old Kingdom, second one, the period of Middle Kingdom, and the third one, the period of New Kingdom. Let's see one by one. The period of Old Kingdom, it is also known as the period of pyramids. The pharaohs of this period were very strong. Pharaoh appointed vizier, the prime minister. Vizier or the prime minister headed the administration, justice and treasury. He was assisted by central and local officers in administration. The local officers collected taxes and looked after law and order, whereas the central officers maintained the records and the accounts. This is the explanation relating to the period of Old Kingdom. Then second one, the period of Middle Kingdom. It is also known as the period of feudal lords. During this period, lords or feudal lords became more powerful than the pharaohs. It led to many internal wars and anarchy. Because of the weakness of pharaohs, landlords became powerful. It led to many internal wars and anarchy. The authority of pharaohs was restored by Emperor Amenhotep I. These are the explanations relating to the period of Middle Kingdom. Then third one, the period of New Kingdom. During the New Kingdom, the kings raised a powerful army and built a very strong empire. Thutmose I conquered new territories and expanded the empire. Thutmose I is considered the greatest ruler of Egyptian civilization. His daughter Hatshepsut succeeded him. She is known as the first empress in the history of the world. Hatshepsut was regarded as the first empress of the world. She ruled for 21 years. Question number 4. Write a short note on learning and literature of Egyptian civilization. Learning and literature, or education and literature of Egyptian civilization. Egyptians developed pictographic writing. It is one of the earliest forms of writing. Egyptian writing is called hieroglyphics. Glyph means a sign. Hieroglyphics contains hundreds of signs. Some of them stand for complete words, while others represent sounds. Papyrus was used for writing. Literature. They produced many books like the Book of Dead, Coffin Text, The Story of Shipwrecked Sailor, The Tale of Anupu and Vitu, etc. are the important books discovered. The Egyptians had fair knowledge of medicine, geometry, calendars, astronomy, and mathematics. Most of the scholars of ancient Egypt belongs to priestly class. These are the explanations relating to the important literary contributions. The construction of huge pyramids proves beyond doubt that Egyptians had sound knowledge of geometry and arithmetic. They could measure the areas of triangles, rectangles, squares, circles, and hexagons. They had clear idea about addition, subtraction, and division. However, they had no idea about multiplication. They were the first to develop the fraction system. So, they made a clear distinction between stars and planets. Their calendar was based on sun and known as solar calendar. They developed the calendar of 365 days with 12 months in a year, of 30 days in each month. They divided the year into three seasons of 4 months each, rising and receding of the Nile stood for the first season, cultivation and growing of the plants stood for the second, and the third for the harvest. This is the explanation relating to the calendar. At the age of 5, the child was sent to the teacher. Relating to the education, at the age of 5, the child was sent to the teacher. It was given education for 12 years. They will get education for 12 years. The temples were the centers of education. Higher education was given by officials. In totally, the education was controlled by the state. Question number 5. Write a note on art and architecture of Egyptians. Egyptians were great builders. They developed fine arts. Their art and architecture reflected their culture. They built temples for their gods and pyramids for to bury their kings. The walls of temples and pyramids are carved with beautiful sculptures. The walls of temples and pyramids are carved with beautiful sculptures and decorated with beautiful paintings. They used sandstone, limestone, granite, and wood to carve the statues. For carving the statues, they used sandstone, limestone, granite, and wood to carve the statues. They had well organized and highly skilled artists, craftsmen, and laborers. Then the Pyramid of Giza. The Pyramid of Giza is the tomb of King Khufu. It is one of the wonders of ancient world. It is the biggest pyramid. Includes 746 into 486 into 481 feet high. 23 lakhs stone blocks of average 2.5 ton weight were used. It occupies 13 acres of area. A million slaves worked for 20 years to complete it. The pyramids are the fine examples of their outstanding technical knowledge and sound administrative ability of the Egyptians. The construction of this kind of pyramids shows their outstanding technical knowledge and sound administration. Then the Sphinx. It has the head of man and body of lion. Sphinx has the head of man and body of a lion. It is carved by the Emperor Khafre. It is 240 feet long and 66 feet high, carved out in a single stone. They use monolithic statue for the construction or erection of the Sphinx. The Luxor Temple. It had a magnificent entrance. The road in front of it is lined with 365 statues of sphinxes. Next, the part number 2. Answer in 30 to 40 sentences. Each carries 10 marks. Here, one long answer question is explained relating to Egyptian civilization. Describe the contributions of Egyptian civilization. Describe the contributions of Egyptian civilization. Introduction. Egyptian civilization developed on the river bank of Nile. Probably their civilization is the oldest civilizations of the world. Following are the important contributions of the Egyptian civilization. So the Egyptian civilization developed on the river bank of Nile. So it is considered as one of the oldest civilizations in the world. The first one, political contributions. The pharaohs. The Egyptian kings were called pharaohs. They were considered as representatives of God on earth. The pharaoh Menes united south and north, made Memphis as his capital. The strong central government with absolute monarchy, a well-controlled administration, and strict implementation of laws were the basic features of Egyptian society. A strong central government with absolute monarchy, a well-controlled administration, and strict implementation of laws were the basic features of Egyptian civilization. It means the Egyptians constructed a strong political institutions. So it is also considered as one of the important contributions of Egyptians to the world. Relating to the dynastic rule of Egypt, The rule of dynasties can be divided into three parts. They are the period of Old Kingdom, the period of Middle Kingdom, the period of New Kingdom. Thutmose first conquered new territories and expanded the empire. His daughter Hatshepsut succeeded him. She is known as the first empress in the history of the world. Hatshepsut is known as the first empress in the history of the world. Then the social condition. Egypt had a well-organized society. There were three classes, namely the upper class, the middle class, and the slaves. The upper class includes the royal family, the priests, the nobles, and the military officers. The middle class includes physicians, scribes, craftsmen, merchants, and farmers. In the third or lower class, the slaves formed the last strata of the society. Slaves belongs to lower strata of the society. Status of women. Egyptian women enjoyed an exceptionally high status. Such a high status was not enjoyed by the women of any other civilization. That is why the Egyptian civilization has the credit of being ruled by Hatshepsut, the first empress in the world. It shows the status of women. Economic condition. It was an agrarian economy. Egyptian economy was an agrarian economy. Thanks to Nile, they had prosperous agriculture. Because of the River Nile, they had prosperous agriculture. They grew crops like wheat, barley, cotton, peas, garlic, and variety of fruits and vegetables. Crafts and manufacturers. Egyptians developed a variety of crafts and manufacturing. Stone cutters, masons, carpenters, jewelers, potters, etc. added to the luxury, comforts, and richness of life. Trade and commerce. Egyptians had developed both internal and external trade. Both internal and external trade was existed. They traded with the people of Syria, Lebanon, and Ammon. They maintained trade relations with the Mediterranean world, including Syria, Lebanon, and Ammon. Barter system was prevailed during Egyptian civilization. Barter system or exchange of the commodities or existed. Religion played a significant role in the life of the people. Worship of nature and many gods is common in Egyptian civilization. Amun-Ra was the king of the gods. Amun-Ra was the king of the gods. He was believed to be the creator of Egypt. Ra was the sun god. Osiris, the god of the dead or underworld. Ra was the sun god. Osiris, the god of the dead or underworld. Isis was the goddess of motherhood. Isis was the goddess of motherhood and the wife of Osiris. Horus, Hathor, etc. were the minor gods. In this way, the Egyptians worshipped many gods, or polytheism was existed. Egyptians built many temples for the gods. They believed in the transmigration of souls and they preserved the dead bodies, and these dead bodies known as mummies. Priests enjoyed a high status in Egyptian society. Kings was the heads of the religion. Learning and literature. Egyptians developed pictographic writing. It is one of the earliest forms of writing. Egyptian writing is called hieroglyphics. Hieroglyphics contains hundreds of signs. Papyrus was used for writing. Relating to the literature, the Book of Dead, Coffin Text, The Story of Shipwrecked Sailor, The Tale of Anupu and Bitu, etc. are the important books discovered. Egyptians had fair knowledge of medicine, geometry, calendars, astronomy, and mathematics. Most of the scholars of ancient Egypt belonged to priestly class. So these are the explanations relating to the education, knowledge of medicine, geometry, calendar, astronomy, and mathematics was familiar for the Egyptians. The construction of huge pyramids proves beyond doubt that Egyptians had sound knowledge of geometry and arithmetic. They could measure the areas of triangles, rectangles, squares, circles, and hexagons. So they were aware of geometry and arithmetic. They made a clear distinction between stars and planets. Their calendar was based on sun and known as solar calendar. They know about calendar, and their calendar was based on sun. They developed the calendar of 365 days with 12 months in a year of 30 days in each month. Related to the education, at the age of 5, the child was sent to the teacher. It was given education for 12 years. The temples were the centers of education. The education was controlled by the state. Then art and architecture. Egyptians were great builders. They developed fine arts. Their art and architecture reflected their culture. They built temples for their gods and pyramids to bury their kings. The Pyramid of Giza. It is the tomb of King Khufu. It is one of the wonders of ancient world. It is the biggest pyramid. It occupies 13 acres of area. The pyramids are the fine examples of their outstanding technical knowledge and sound administrative ability. The Sphinx. Sphinx has the head of a man and body of a lion. It is 240 feet long and 66 feet high, carved out in a single stone. Then the Luxor Temple. Luxor temple. It had a magnificent entrance. The road in front of it is lined with 365 statues of sphinxes. Conclusion. Egyptian civilization was a great civilization which existed around 7000 to 3000 BCE. During the span of these 4000 years, they produced innumerable contributions. The pyramids, the temples, Sphinx, hieroglyphic writings are the greatest contributions to the world. Dear students, here I stop my explanations on 5 must and 10 must questions of Egyptian civilization. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell button for further notifications. Thank you all.